With you, another with the word of God once again, rescued from evil. And boy, this whole world we're living in is evil, isn't it? We'd like to get straight into the message today here live at 5 for those of you listening to us live, and for those of you listening to us maybe in the future or sometime on YouTube, God bless you. So glad you joined us. Deliver me, it says in the 140th Psalm, the first verse, deliver me from the evil man. Preserve me from the violent man. So the psalmist was asking God to deliver him from evil, the evil man and the violent person. And what really led me to this verse and this sermon today is really found in Isaiah, the 57th chapter and the first verse. I'd like to read that to you. It says, the righteous perisheth. Now, I've shared many times what righteous, the best way I know to explain righteousness, and that's someone that's in right standing with God, or righteousness is to be in right standing with God. It says here in the 57th chapter in the first verse of Isaiah, the righteous perisheth, and no man layeth it to heart. In other words, no man really understands why. When someone that's a good Christian person dies, especially in an untimely death or whatever it might be, we're never ready to give our loved ones up. None of us are. And merciful men are taken away. Men full of mercy are taken away. And then he explains it. Listen close to the end of this verse. None considering that the righteous is taken away from the evil to come, he shall enter into peace. The next verse starts out. Thank God forever. They shall rest in their beds. Glory to God. So, we see that God saves us from the evil. And sometimes God takes us on home to heaven so that we can be saved from the many pains that we might have to go through if we're here. So it says, none considering that the righteous is taken away from the evil to come. Well, we know that the church is going to be raptured. And none of us know the day nor the hour, but we can watch the signs of the time. And we know that that day will come. And many of us think that it's probably very close, but no man knows. But this much I do know, that God will deliver me from the evil to come. Thank God forever, and he will deliver you, all of his children. If you put your faith and trust in him, you'll see that God is there to deliver you from the evil man, from the violent man, from the evil of this old world. Thank God we're not part of it. When you're truly born of the Spirit of God and you're saved beyond a shadow of a doubt, thank God forever. You don't want anything to do with darkness and the principalities of it. You don't want anything to do with the evil that's going on in the world today. A lot of people in the name of God commit evil things, and in the name of churches, they do evil things. A lot of darkness in the world, rioting and carrying on, and murder and lying and hatefulness like we've never seen. But thank God forever for Jesus. He will deliver us. Thank God from the evil man. He will deliver us from the violent man. I love this verse because it comforts me in knowing that Christians that die young, God just delivered them. Thank God from evil that was coming their way. Thank God for his word. Aren't you glad for the word of God today that's always there to guide us and comfort us? Thank God and help us to understand what we need to understand. I'm so glad for the word of God. The righteous perisheth, thank God it says, and no man layeth at the heart, and merciful men are taken away. None considering, it says, that the righteous is taken away from the evil to come. I'm so glad that God has a time for each one of us, thank God, and he has a place that he's already preparing for us. The Bible says he went away to prepare us a place that where he is, we may be also. Yes, it's evil times, but I don't think think, as I've said many times, we've seen anything yet. I believe that evil is coming upon this world, and darkness is getting darker all the time. And that's another sermon I may have to preach very shortly. I believe with all my heart that we're living in dark times, and I believe it's going to get darker. And I believe, thank God forever, that if you've got the light of the gospel in your heart, it will be a lamp unto your feet and a light unto your path. The Bible says His word is just that. It's a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. And you'll find that the grace of God will be there for you. Thank God, regardless of what man says or has to think about it, or man tries to do about it, God's word is forever settled in heaven, and you can bank on it. Thank God, if God said it, that settles it. Thank God forever. I'm glad that the word of God is a lamp unto my feet. I'm glad, thank God forever, that it enlightens the path that I have to walk in this old dark world, and gives me the illumination I need. Thank God to see my way safely through the bumps in the road, and the mud and the muck, to keep me from getting stuck, to keep me from getting in a rut that will pull me down and keep me from going the direction God would have me to go. I've shared this before, but I'll share it one more time. They say on the old Oregon Trail, there used to be a sign on one of the east ends of it as people were heading west, and it said, "Don't get in this rut, because you'll be in it for the next 40 miles. Boy, that'd be a long time to be in a rut with the old wagons when they didn't have rubber tires, wouldn't it? And that's what happens. If we're not careful, we'll get in a rut, and that rut, we'll have to run it out. But we don't have to get in those ruts if we let the Word of God be a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. Thank God forever. It will enlighten the way for us. It will help us to avoid those places. It will help us to walk in straight and the narrow way and to overcome evil with good. I found that the Word of God always has the answers, thank God, that we need. I found that the grace of God is always there to give me the comfort I need by His sweet Holy Spirit. Thank God to know that my name is written down in the Lamb's Book of Life. Thank God, and if He calls me away today and helps me avoid the evil that's coming my way, I say praise God. If He lets me live another day and He keeps the evil out of my path by His word, I say praise God. I say I'm a winner either way. If I go or if I stay, it doesn't matter. Thank God forever, whether we stay or go. What matters is we're in the will of God, that we're trusting Jesus with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength. Thank God to get us through. Thank God the trials of life and the temptations and the snares and the things that Satan has to throw our way. Thank God if we just put our faith and trust in the Lord Jesus Christ, we're going to make it through. There's no doubt about it. Thank God He's the captain. Thank God, and He always leads us right. He is, thank God, the captain of my soul. He is the anchor in a time of storm. He's the wheel in the middle of the wheel. Thank God He's the great I Am. He is, glory to God, the Savior and the Lord of my life. Thank God for Jesus. Thank God, the author and the finisher of my faith. The Lion of Judah, the Bride and the Morning Star, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. He is, thank God, Jesus. His name is Emmanuel, because being interpreted, that means God with us. And I find that He is with us through everything we walk through in life. He's with me when I'm asleep. He's with me when I'm awake. He's with me when I'm healthy. He's with me when I'm sick. He's with me while I'm alive. He'll be with me, glory to God, when I'm dying. Thank God, O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? Thank God He came to deliver us from the evil of this world, and His word will stand when everything else fails. Woo! Glory to God for Jesus. Thank you, Lord Christ, for saving my soul. Thank you for your blessed word today and your goodness that led me to repentance. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for being a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thank you, Jesus, for saving a wretch like me. Woo! Glory to his name. Well, the righteous perisheth and no man layeth at the heart. Well, we need to lay at the heart that we're saved from the evil coming our way. Bless God forever. This is Preacher Rick. Our time has expired one more day. Until the next time, beloved, we love you all. Push that share button. Get the word of God out while you can. God bless you. Bye-bye.